Hi, welcome to Kitchen Web Stories. Today's recipe is Moong Dal and Millet Dosa with Red Capsicum Chutney. This is a no fermentation recipe with just a 30 minute soaking time and then grinding. This recipe especially comes to rescue when you're really, really tired, and it's got added benefits of carrot and bottle gourd. Yes, you heard me right. So let's just start the recipe. I've taken 1 cup of yellow moong dal in a bowl, and also 1/2 cup of foxtail millet. Or tenai. We're going to give it once a rinse with water and soak this in hot water for 30 minutes. The water which I'm pouring right now is hot water. It's from the kettle. Let's just give it all a mix so that it gets soaked well. And this soaking is just for 30 minutes. You can even soak it longer if you have more time. Next, I've taken 1 bottle gourd. Okay, and I'm going to remove or peel the skin. You can use a peeler, but I feel it doesn't get done properly with the peeler, so I'm just using the knife here. I have finely grated the dudhi or lauki here, and also grated 1 medium-sized carrot. We're gonna add both of this to the moong dal batter. Next, I've taken 1 red bell pepper or red capsicum, which is the hero of our chutney today, and also 1 onion, which is in medium size. I've taken a red onion. You can use a white or a brown one or pink one. So let's just remove the seeds of it and just roughly chop the capsicum in or the bell pepper in whichever size shape you want, as we're gonna saute it in oil. I've chopped the bell pepper and also the onions in a horizontal way. Next, for the chutney, I've taken 3 red chilies and 1 spoon of urad dal, 1 spoon of chana dal, and a little bit of oil. We're gonna roast it, just see that it doesn't get too burnt. And once it is nicely roasted, we're gonna cool it and add it to the blender to make a chutney. In the same pan, we're gonna add the chopped onions and capsicum, the red capsicum. You can even use green capsicum if you don't have a red capsicum. You can even try making chutney with a yellow capsicum. So that's of your choice. Just saute it till it's slightly brown. And once it is kind of roasted, you can switch off the pan, cool it, and then we'll transfer it to a blender. I think it's almost done here. So let's just cool this off and we'll add it to the blender once it's cooled to make a chutney. So now let's come back to the soaked moong dal and foxtail millet. It is soaked quite well. I've added it into a blender here. And just to show you all that the moong dal has become a bit nice and soft, it's soaked well. See, when I try to break it into a piece, it's kind of breaking off. It is soft. I'm adding 2 green chilies and a ginger piece also to the blender jar. See, I've blended the moong dal and foxtail millet along with the green chili and ginger. I'll pour it into a bowl. Yeah, it's come out really nice and fine, like normal idli or dosa batter. You can even make idlis out of this. See, look at the consistency. It's not very flowing, not very thin, neither not very too thick. It's just fine. We're gonna add the grated carrot and bottle gourd to this moong dal batter. If you don't want to add this, you can even skip, or you could add only bottle gourd, or you can add only carrot, or you can just avoid adding more of these and just add only onions or coriander or any other thing of your choice. The color of sorakai or lauki, bottle gourd, call it whatever you want, has changed a bit, which is quite normal. Let's add a little bit of salt and give it a nice mix again. And the batter is ready. This is absolutely a no fermentation batter, a no fermentation recipe, which is very quick. If you want to make it a bit more soft, you can add a little bit of Eno baking soda, but I have not. The onion and capsicum has cooled, transfer it to a jar. Let's add a little bit of salt and let's quickly grind it into a nice chutney. Wow, I've ground it here, and look at the color of the red capsicum chutney. It's really nice and looks really tempting. Let's quickly start making the dosas now. I've heated a pan and taken a ladle full of moong dal batter. Give it a nice quick spread in circles, round and round across the pan. You can even make it a bit more thin by just scraping the batter from the top side so that it becomes really thin and crisp. But I like it this way. Drizzle in a little bit of oil on top. And you're gonna cook it for maybe a minute or so, 1 or 2 minutes, till the underneath side gets cooked. Once it's done, we're gonna give it a nice flip. Kind of done now from the underneath. And ta-da! Here I flipped it. It's come out really nice. It's cooked well. Okay, that's it. So your crispy dosa is ready. Let's do the tadka or talipio for the chutney. 1 spoon of mustard seed, 1 spoon of oratal, and a few curry leaves in oil. And it's crackled and done. I'm gonna add this seasoning on top of the red capsicum chutney, which I've taken over here in a bowl. Oh, trust me, it's so yummy. Do try this chutney out for your normal dosas and let me know in the comment section how it was. I have another capsicum recipe, which is the onion capsicum gravy. Do check that out too in my videos. Do like, share, subscribe to Kitchen Web Stories if you like this video. And a very big thank you to all who have supported me. Thank you.